the Holy Spirit strengthen you during your temptation to desperate Christ ever seen.
Christ Jesus.
Lord Jesus, the Holy Spirit move you during your passion to death and resurrection. Lord, mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We only God have mercy on us and give us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made your people partakers of your redemption, grant, we pray, that we may confess to men of thanks for the resurrection of the Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever. Amen.
Amen.
Which he speaks. We do not know what he means.
scriptures when we pick up these little historical tidbits from the readings. So today we hear that Paul met a Jew named Aquila and his wife Priscilla, because Claudius, the emperor, had expelled all the Jews from Rome. And that's recorded in non-biblical literature, 49 AD, because of disruptions in Rome, because of a certain Crescens, and people think this was the Christ being proclaimed in Roman synagogues. Claudius got sick of it and said, "Jews, get out of here," and he banned them. And so they came to meet Paul, this couple. And they were tent makers by trade, so they shared a common occupation, which is of interest too. So he got to know them and work with them, discovered that there was a Christian community in Rome which he did not found. And together they worked in Corinth, Sin City, on one of the coastlines of Greece. And they worked hard at proclaiming the gospel. And as they went into the Jewish synagogues trying to proclaim the Christ, they caused upset again, and they kept getting expelled. So they said, "Okay, we'll go to the Gentiles," where they found a more receptive audience. You ever hear the proverb, making lemonade out of lemons? That's what they were doing. And that's where the Holy Spirit worked through them and opened up wide God's plan in the whole world. So could we make lemonade out of our lemons these days? With masks, 6 feet, all the stuff we're doing to be able to worship publicly and go to different stores and such. I wonder. I think there's great creativity going on online right now. There's different ways people are reaching out. Recently read a story in St. Louis Review of my classmates, Steve Robeson, who's down in, gosh, where is it? Concord Hill, down in Washington County. Parked his car at a busy crossroads and just sat out there with a sign and talked to people as they went by. Who knows what the Holy Spirit might stir up in us during these times of Lent. And so, this, starting today, used to be the rest of the Feast of the Ascension. From now until Pentecost, a novena to the Holy Spirit to be prayed in preparation for the feast. And so, especially the church is turning her attention to the Holy Spirit. We can do that as well in our prayer. I'd like to conclude this preached word with a particular prayer that I'll read off the back of the Missal that very day. If you know that you can pray with me, of course. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created. You shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who has instructed the hearts of your faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant by the same Holy Spirit we may have a right judgment in all things, and evermore rejoice with consolations. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let's pray our petitions of faith. Spirit, we pray.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of creation, who have been to receive the wine of our Lord, who provide the food and hands to the mouth of the spiritual.
Blessed be God forever. Mystery of faith, when we eat this bread and drink this cup,
we proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes.
Therefore, we celebrate the Lord with his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you, help us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, by the help of your mercy, we may be bold to be sent to save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours,
Lord Jesus Christ, who sent your house, peace and peace, life and sin. Look down on our sins, but on the faith of your church, be gracious to me, peace and unity, and according to your will, live and reign forever. Amen.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Body of Christ. us pray.